All right, so let's have a look at the boards then, I guess. So we'll start with DCB. He's up at the top on almost full health. Fair play. Brew poison looks like brew poison, good stuff.
I've never seen this build before.
It's an enigma. Let's work out how he's pedaling this off.
I like what he's doing with the Lycan. I always love Lycan plus another Savage in the early game. Like, it's such a solid play, because he does have Lifestealer available to him, right? So if he wants to, he can play Brutes with Alk and Lifestealer one, right?
Yeah, but he's going one step further, and he's made that Savage the Magnus so that he can throw in the NP instead of the Breaker and Lifestealer that he's got. And...
Exactly.
Yep. This is pretty...
I like the way he has that set up, right? Let's see. On the other hand, Rabbit is also streaking. Currently, probably playing level up Heartless Hunter. If I had to guess, he has like Anti-Mage Benched, he has Fudges. Let's see.
Another Heartless, good stuff. Good mid game. Maiko's pair gaming. Ooh.
Let's see what Maiko's
doing. Oh my god!
Maiko, you're bored!
That's amazing. He's truly channeling my essence right now.
Wow. Hits the Queen of Pain. Apparently not channeling your essence.
Oh, never mind. Never mind. That would never have happened.
So without looking at the low HP board, how many brawny kills would you like to see by now? He's going brawnies. How many do you want to see again?
No, another
round 12, at least 20.
Yeah,
well,
definitely.
Well, he's almost there.
Look, here's the thing, right? When I started DigiCup, everybody always told me fucking... I had so many people, like, message me or reach out to me about it. Brawny is going to be overpowered in every single game. And every fucking game we've spectated today, there's been a Brawny. And every game, they have a shit early game and they have a really tough time. Maybe Noob God can be the one to pull it out and can actually make it succeed in this game.
Sure, at like, you know, 10 rounds from now, if he happens to already have a good early game going on, it could certainly
be good. He's looking real dead, but now he's 8 out of 9 on the jugger. He just hit 2 jugs.
Oh my god. Oh, he's 8 out of 9 on the bristle. Oh, he's got the bristle,
He's got it.
All right. This might be his comeback mode. Burka now struggling.
Well, Burka's got an interesting spot because I've been watching him for a little minute, and he's gone for the two healers because he's got the heal and steal NO in the brute poison, so he's kept the dazzle obviously, and then thrown in a treant to boot. But he's also got a 2-star Lina, and he's trying to now find Rubik. And by the looks of it, like the Quap, he's still holding on to, even though he's got Viper, he's holding on to the Quap for the magic damage in case he goes. Like, he's got 3 mages in, he's got this Puck in as well, so.
There has to be a way for this to make sense, right? So let's look. Let's say he goes out of Lycan down the road, and let's say he goes out of Spearbreaker for something
humans.
Like a Doom, and levels up and gets a Troll in, right? Ooh, actually hits the Rubik. All right,
Rubik's big.
So the question here is: do you drop Poisoner? You drop the Lycan? Okay, take.
Yeah, I think you drop Lycan and you just like. Maybe consider, because there's no Barricade Boys in this tournament, right? Maybe consider that Doom.
I think you sell the Lycan now.
Yeah.
You only needed him for the human in terms of alliances. Yes, he's incredibly good, but you're going to probably find something better like Cottle, like another Dragon Knight.
Yes, I think I agree with you. Also,
Rubik getting doomed here.
Burka,
I'm still watching Burka here, but yeah, Rubik just got doomed.
Yeah, Burka has good point standings, and Neiman or Maiko does too. Maiko is getting dropped or close to dropping. The top of everything is crumbling. Maiko, Burka, TMZ are not doing well, and it's actually very interesting to see because those are our top three for this current lobby. Maiko going out 8th place, only getting 1 point. He's really going to have to hope that the bottom doesn't, you know, throw down the top right now.
Who did he hit in that last round, actually? I was meaning to keep an eye on that.
Was it
DCB? DCB, yes. DCB streaking. DCB is in a solid position. DCB might consider him... secure him his top 4 right
Rabbit's
now.
Positioning again. Okay, it just changed. Okay.
Let's see. Right now, DCB is in 4th after game 2, but not by a substantial margin, so he has to be afraid, right? I also want to say, if Niemand drops here without making top four, he is 100% out.
Just okay.
100% out. Yeah, that's definitely unusual because Niemand is a very good gamer, right? Yeah. He's very good at this game.
It is interesting that this lobby is 7 level builds.
Let's see. Yeah, I think TMZ was looking for some role mage early on, but just couldn't find it to start his units and just went for the levels, right?
I'm watching Rabbit.
I think that's him out.
Ooh, and Niemand's out, yeah.
Yes.
TMZ's in trouble.
Costs. Need my forecasts.
He's got Where 5 humans. He's got a Cottle on the bench.
I mean, also, again, like, Burke and TMZ are both running mages, so, like, you're basically auto-loss on a one-star board with PB versus any sort of okay mages.
Do you like the 2-star Kunker over the Cottle on the bench?
I'm
not sure I do. I think he needs to Cottle people the fuck out of here.
Oh, not with 5 humans, no. I don't think so.
If he needed it for the humans, then I stand by it all day long. But given that he doesn't, I think it's horses, bitch. Burka's out.
Burka is out. Burka, I mean, the thing about Burka is his points from, like, the first two games, they were solid. They were rock solid. So, could that be enough for him? I think it may be. But there's always that comeback potential, especially by the brawny gamer, should they top one this game.
Chin up just found a Mirana 2 just at the moment that he hits TMZ. Let's see whether this is the end of TMZ.
Fire Scream, thanks for the raid. Hello, you're walking in on the conclusion of this game. TMZ dropped by Chin Map. Rabbit loses to the brawny board. The brawny board making the massive comeback. Could that be enough?
We have Poison Brute, 2 Heartless Hunter, and a Brawny. Interesting. And there's a Cadence Blade on Rabbit.
Yeah, Cadence coming into play. There is Refresher Beastmaster up and running. Is this Brawny going to have enough? He has 150 kill count. Here's another thing that I'm kind of concerned about. Let's say, for the sake of argument, the Brawny's reach is number one here. Is it actually sufficient? That's, like, what I'm most worried about for him right now. Like, let's say he does make it. I'm not really sure. Cadence is allowed in play after round 24 or at the start of round 25. Let's see.
Yeah, we got Rabbit HH in Thrall now with a Cadence Blade. I'm fully expecting to see right here some seriously. Oh, there it is! There's the Bristle and Thrall.
Oh yes, the Bristle and Thrall.
That's a Padlin right there.
And that is going to be a big hit to Noob like God. 14, Michael, 13. I do think you will be alright. I really do. If I had to boldly, like, predict, there is a very reasonable chance that you make it. All right, let's see. Can the Brawny board win? That's what I'm most curious about.
He doomed the tide, so prevented the ravage, enthralls the breaker. The focus damage.
Is that going to be lethal? DCB exact lethal.
DCB on 4th of exact lethal. Brawny's going to drop here, and now we have
the Brawny out.
Everything that you hope to see: Heartless Hunter versus Heartless Hunter.
Oh, DCB getting exactly lethal there.
If he had
at least third place, I would make a case that DCB could feel confident, right? But now that he has gone fourth, I am so terrified for him that he could be knocked here. We will see as a result from this lobby, because the current top four, let's look at the placements that I have so far. And Rabbit both were not in the top four from our previous games. So they are about to get 12 or 11 and 14 points divided amongst them, right? That could be enough with DCB getting fourth here to knock DCB on his ass. And that would be so painful when it's a scam. Rabbit smacks them.
20 damage to 19 health. Okay.
Oh, that's it. Wow. All right.
HH wins.
Screenshot.
Yeah, I'm gonna screenshot that. All right, Drayson, would you care to give us some closing statements?
Closing statement is Heartless Hunter kicks ass.
Who would have thought? Right?
Oh, yeah. Who would have seen that coming?
That was nuts.
Today, I think what's interesting is that it's not just Poison Brood in terms of level gaming, right? Yeah. Like, the other level builds, Warriors, Hunters.
Saw
Knights.
Yeah, the TMZ Warriors. I really like that, actually.
Yeah, cool. TMZ top bond with level Warriors.
Talk me through that.
He just played good stuff in the early game and just focused on the Warriors later on.
It was literally Warrior Heartless Trolls for the early game. I think he splashed a Lycan too at some point in time. Eventually ended up going into...
Yeah, the Lycan was...
Warriors plus like every anti-mage thing that exists in the game, like the mech, essentially. Four-skilled, Pipe, Usa, like everything. Just the whole nine yards.
The great thing about leveling warriors, or just warriors in general, even if you're rolling on them, is you have the most natural tech to go for four scales in any build that exists in this game. Mm-hmm. Because you have two warriors in that tag already, and Medusa is always going to be a good unit, right? Regardless of what you're playing, you're never going to go, fuck, shit, I got to play a Medusa. What a bad unit. No, that's not what happens. If you have the space for a Medusa, you're all right. So then it just becomes, I have to play either Venomancer or I have to play...
Slark.
Slark, yeah. I mean, that's...
Everybody likes to play Slark. I understand.
I've actually done that with Venomancer, and instead of Shadow Shaman, I've gone for Dazzle as my troll, because that leads you to play a very easy Poison edition. And I actually kind of like that, because I play NO every single time that I play that build. So, I believe if... TMZ was actually playing...
Alexander the Great confirmed.
Yes, exactly. That's TMZ. Yeah, no, TMZ was playing Dazzle in his game. He was playing all-out attack NO. So if he's up against a right-click-based comp rather than mages, he keeps around his Venomancer, and he just plays a Poisoner like Viper instead of his Lycan. And suddenly he also has Poisoners and four scales to his in his build. Which I think is really good, because it helps you counter the two playstyles that he might have been up against. But I think...
That's a lot of combinations, that's a lot of alliances, but that's some shaky units.
Like, I don't know, like, you're running Dusa 2, Tai 2, Troll 2, your Kunkka is always going to be relatively solid, Putch is always a pretty good unit. And then you have Poisoners AOA. Like, yeah, there are some units in that are maybe a little bit shaky, but on the other hand, Slaughter gives you your scales, and if you're at that point already, you might as well go for the full six. It ended up working really great against Poison Brood, because they don't have that much damage that isn't physical.
Yep. I actually liked it a lot better than what I normally would see with somebody who's like in the mindset of six warrior, because it felt a lot more natural in terms of like how he progressed into it. It wasn't just like, I'm sitting on five warriors.
Yes, that is
very
true.
My six warriors is not like, hey, we're like all in on this, but you know, pretty anemic in the mid game when we're like, where's Tidehunter? Where's Troll Warlord? Like, where's the thing that kind of like lets us come online? He played a very, very consistent game the entire time.